Hello friends, today we are going to discuss the another problem of this toothed wheel or gear wheels. Okay, so see, directly we take the problem. This is what statement of the problem. The problem number 7, a pair of gears having 40 and 20 teeth respectively are rotating in mesh. The speed of the smaller being 2000 rpm, determine the velocity of sliding between the gear teeth faces at the point of engagement, at the pitch point, and at the point of disengagement. If the smaller gear is driver, assume that gear teeth are 20 degree involute form, addendum length is 5 mm and the module is 5 mm. Also find the angle through which the pinion turns while any pair of teeth are in contact. So, see the problem. I will explain one by one, line by line. Okay. So, pair of gears having 40 and 20 teeth respectively. This 40 teeth and this 20 teeth. The 40 teeth may be on larger gear and 20 teeth may be on smaller gear. Are rotating mesh. Okay. The speed of the smaller being 2000 rpm. This is what speed of the smaller one. That is what np. Okay, n is what speed. Next, determine the velocity of sliding of the gear teeth. That is what determine the velocity of sliding. What they want to find out, what they want answer. That is what velocity of sliding between the gear teeth faces at the point of engagement. That means they want the velocity of sliding at the point of engagement. Second, at the pitch point. That is what second one is what? At the pitch point. Okay. Third one is what? At the point of disengagement. That means they want to find out the velocity of sliding at the first thing is that. That is what? At the engagement. That is mean what? At starting position. Next is what? At pitch point. That will be a zero. Okay. And the point of disengagement. That is what? End point. Okay. If the smaller gear is a driver, here is what? The smaller gear is driver, not a driven. Okay. Assume that gear teeth are 20 degree involute form. That is what? Here 5, that is angle of gear teeth that is given. 5 angle is given. 5 is equal to 20 degree. Okay. Addendum length is 5 mm. The length of addendum is given. That is what? 5 mm. Next, module is 5 mm. Again, module is given, that is small m is equal to 5 mm. Also, find the angle through which the pinion turns while any pair of teeth are in contact. So, we have to find out the angle through which the pinion turns. That is what angle through which pinion we have to find out. Now, what are the findings? First finding is that velocity of sliding at the three conditions. That is, first is what? At the point of engagement, at the pitch point, and third one is what? At the disengagement. And second finding is that angle turn through which the pinion turns while the any pair of teeth are in contact. So first thing is that write down whatever data is given. So solution, see here, what is given? Capital T, that is number of teeth on larger gear is given, that is 40. Again, small t is given, that is the number of teeth on smaller, that is what 20. Again, n1, or simply say this is what np. Okay, that is what 200 rpm, that is what speed of smaller one is what 2000 rpm. Again, phi is given, that is what 20 degree. Okay, addendum is equal to 5 mm, and again m is equal to, that m is nothing but module is equal to 5 mm. So first thing is that we have to find out the capital R, small r, capital R and small r. Okay, in that case we have to find out the omega 1. Okay, so omega 1 is equal to what? 2 pi n1 divided by 60. So 2 pi is what? Constant. Again, n1 is given, that is what? 2000 divided by this 60. So we got here omega 1 is equal to 209.5 radian per second. This is what angular velocity of this smaller gear. Now, angular velocity of larger gear. Now, we know that there is a relation between the angular velocity and number of teeth. The angular velocity and number of teeth are inversely proportional. That is what omega 2 divided by omega 1 is equal to small t divided by capital T. Okay, so omega 1, this is nothing but what? Angular velocity of smaller gear. Omega 2, that is what? Angular velocity of larger gear. small t, that is what number of teeth on smaller gear, and capital T is equal to what number of teeth on larger gear. Okay, so put the values. We already got your value of omega 1, that is 209.5, put here, that is 209.5. okay, smaller teeth, that is small t is given in problem, that is what 20, and capital T, that is what 40, put here. So by calculation we got here 209.5 into 20 divided by 40 is equal to, we got here this 104.75, that is 104.75 radian per second. This is nothing but the velocity of the angular velocity of larger gear, that is omega 2. That is what omega 2 divided by omega 1 is equal to what, small t divided by capital T. Okay, now pitch circle radius of smaller gear. Always find first, this is what first, whenever you want to find out the solutions, first thing is that we have to find out the small r, capital R, small r and capital R. So small r is equal to nothing but what, m into t divided by 2. M is what module, small t is nothing but number of teeth on the smaller gear divided by 2. So we have the value of this module, that is what 5 into this t, that is what 20 divided by 2. So we got here R is equal to 50 mm. Next is what, pitch circle radius of larger gear or larger wheel. Okay, so see here, capital R is equal to small m into t divided by 2. Sorry, mistakenly here they are given as m into small t divided by 2, I have written here. So instead of that, write down capital R is equal to small m into here capital T divided by 2. So put the value, m is equal to 5 into this 40 is nothing but what, capital T. I have written here small t mistakenly, so correct it here. This is what capital T divided by 2, 5 into 40 divided by 2. So we got here capital R is equal to 100 mm. Now next is what, radius of addendum circle of smaller gear. So okay, that is what small r is equal to small r plus addendum. So we have the value of addendum in problem, they are given addendum is equal to 5. So and already we find out the small r, so put here 50 plus 5 is equal to 55 mm. This is what radius of addendum circle of smaller gear. Okay, now next is radius of addendum circle of larger gear. So ra, that is what capital ra, this ra stands for radius of addendum circle of the wheel. Okay, this is equal to what, capital R plus addendum. So addendum is what, 5. This capital R is equal to what, radius of this pitch circle of this wheel. So 100 plus 5 is equal to 105 mm. This is what radius of addendum circle of larger gear. The engagement and disengagement of the gear tooth is shown in figure, that is what we shown we seen in the derivation. Okay, the point of K is point of engagement, that is what we know, that the K to L, KL is nothing but what, path of contact. Okay, so KP plus PL, KP is what path of approach, PL is what path of recess, that means KL is what path of contact. So see here, the point K is a point of engagement and P is a pitch point and L is what point of disengagement. We have to find out the velocity here at point K, at point P and point L. Okay, MN is a common tangent at the point of contact. We know that the distance of point of engagement K from the pitch point P or length of path of approach, KP is equal to, we know that the formula, KP is equal to what, under root capital R square minus capital R square into cos square phi, out of this under root bracket, under root, okay, minus R into sine of phi. So we have the value of this RA, that is put here 105, that is 105 square minus 100 square into cos square of 20 minus 100 into sine of 20. So by calculation, put in these values into CALCI or calculator, and we got here this under root term is equal to what, 46.85, okay, minus this 34.2. Okay, this 100 into sine of 20. Okay, so we got here KP is equal to what, 12.65 mm. Now next is what, the distance of the pitch point P from the point of disengagement L or the length of path of recess. So we know that PL is equal to, that is what the path of recess is equal to formula, we know that is what under root capital small r a square minus small r square into cos square of phi minus small r into sin phi. So we have the value of this small r a, that is what 55 square minus 50 square into cos square of 20 minus 50 into sin of 20. So we know that all these values, we already find out this value, put in this formula. So we directly got here under root terms is equal to what 28.6 minus this 15 to sin of 20 is equal to what 17.1. So by calculation we got here 11.5 mm. This is what PL. PL is nothing but what path of recess. So we got here path of recess equal to 11.5 mm. Earlier we find out the path of approach. Here we have find out the path of recess, that is 11.5. Okay. Now velocity of sliding at point of engagement. Now they asked to what velocity of sliding at the point of engagement, at the pitch point and the point of disengagement. So first finding is that velocity of sliding at the point of engagement. Okay, we know that the velocity of sliding at the point of engagement K is equal to, that is VSK. Here V, yes, this stands for velocity of sliding at K is what, at the engagement point K. So this is nothing but what omega 1 plus omega 2 into Kp. Omega 1, this is your velocity of smaller angular velocity of smaller gear. Omega 2, this is the angular velocity of larger gear. This Kp is nothing but what length of path of approach or the at the point of engagement, this is the length. Okay, so we have the value of this omega 1, we have the value of this omega 2, we already find out this value of Kp. So put the values in this formula and calculate, then we got here value, that is VSK, the velocity of sliding at engagement. So omega 1 is what 209.5, omega 2 is what 104.75, and Kp is equal to what 12.65. okay, so see here 209.5 plus 104.75 into 12.65. So we got, by calculation we got value here 3975 mm per second. This is what velocity of sliding at point of engagement. Now next is what velocity of sliding at the pitch point. Okay, since the velocity of sliding is proportional to the distance of the contact point from the pitch point, therefore the velocity of sliding at the point pitch point is zero. What they stated here, what I am stating here, since the velocity of sliding is proportional to the distance of the contact point from the pitch point. Okay, so therefore the velocity of sliding at pitch point is zero. That means there is no any distance from the pitch point. Velocity, we are going to find out velocity, this is proportional to that, the distance which is from the pitch point. Okay, now we are going to find out the velocity at pitch point. There means there is no any distance from the pitch point, that means distance is zero. If we multiply by distance is here, that is value is zero, then we directly got here the velocity of sliding will be zero at the pitch point. That means always see here, always keep in mind that velocity of sliding will be zero at the pitch point, because there is no any distance, there is no any distance between the pitch point, there is no any distance, distance will be zero, so velocity of sliding will be zero. Now next is what velocity of sliding at the point of disengagement. We know that velocity of sliding at the point of disengagement L, that is what starting point is what K, pitch point is P, and end point is what disengagement point is what L. That is KL is equal to what point, length of path of contact, Kp is what approach, PL is what recess, and P is what pitch point. Okay, now we are going to find out velocity of sliding at the point of disengagement, that is at point L. So this VSL, V stands for velocity, L S for sliding, L for the at L point. Velocity of sliding at this point L is equal to what omega 1 plus omega 2 into PL. Okay, so we have the value of this omega 1, we have the value of this omega 2. Again we already calculated the value of this PL, that is your path of recess. Put the values omega 1 is equal to what? 209.5 plus this 104.75 into this path of research, that is 11.5. Take calci and put in the calci, we directly got here VSLL, VSL, that is what velocity of sliding at disengagement is equal to 3614 mm per second. This is what our velocity of sliding at disengagement. That means we already find out this first finding, that is velocity of sliding, in that there are three sub points will be there. That is, first is what velocity of sliding at the engagement, we already find out. Okay, then the velocity of sliding at pitch point, that is what zero we are mentioned here. Again, the velocity of sliding at disengagement, we are already calculated here, that is what 3614 mm per second. Okay, now second finding, the angle through which the pinion turns. For angle turn through the pinion of turns, we have to calculate the path of contact, arc of contact, and afterwards we can calculate this angle through which the pinion turns. So first thing is that we know that length of path of contact is equal to what? KL is equal to KP plus PL. So KP is nothing but what? Path of approach, and PL is what? Path of recess. So this is what? KL is equal to what? 12.65 plus 11.5. So KL is equal to, this KL is nothing but what? Path of contact is equal to what? 24.15 mm. This is what? Path of contact. By using this formula, we can directly find out the arc of contact. The length of arc of contact is equal to this KL divided by cos of phi. We already, in gear terminology or in derivation, we already seen that the length of arc of contact, this is nothing but it is the ratio of length of path of contact divided by cos of phi. This is the length of arc of contact at the first point. Okay, that is what. Okay, so put the value of KL here. That is what 24.15 we already find out, divided by this cos of 20 is equal to what? By calculation we got here 25.7 mm. This is what length of arc of contact. Now next is what? Circumference of smaller gear or pinion. Okay, now we have to find out the circumference, because the angle turned through the pinion, this is what arc of contact divided by PC will be there, that is circular pitch will be there. For this consideration, we are going to see the circumference of smaller gear or pinion. So what is the formula to find out the circumference of gear, that is what, or any circular section? This is what 2 pi r. So 2 pi is constant, r, this is what pinion, that is small r will be there. We have the value of this small r, that is put here 20. So we got here circumference of smaller gear or pinion is what? 314.2 mm. This is what the circumference of the smaller gear or pinion. Now here, see here, angle through which the pinion turns, this is nothing but what? Length of arc of contact into 360 degree divided by circumference of pinion. So we have the value of this length of arc of contact, 360 degree, this is what, constant. We have the value of this circumference of pinion. Put this value into this formula and calculate this term, that is what, 25.7 into this 360 divided by 314.2. Put this values in calci and calculate this term. So we got here angle through which the pinion turns, this is equal to what? 29.45 degree. This is what our second finding. That is what the all findings will be clear here. Clear will be clear here. That means the problem is ends here. Okay, the problem is very simple, in that the only two findings will be there, but in this finding there are sub findings will be there, and we will calculate. This is very simple, but because of the sub findings we said that this problem is huge, or problem is big, or problem is difficult. Nothing will be difficult, just find out the problem or just solve the problem step by step. First thing is that write down whatever given in the problem, and again solve the problem step wise, then you will get the correct answers in the problem. This problem ends here.